Hey guys, my name is Matt Johnson with whoismatt.com, and today I'm going to be showing you the parts you need to build an extremely powerful, high-end monster of a video editing PC for approximately $2,000 in 2021. This build is going to make it easy to edit 4K, 6K, 8K, literally whatever resolution of video you want to edit in Adobe Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve, or basically any other video editing software other than Final Cut, which is Mac only. And as a side note, if you want to edit photos, mix music, or even game and stream, this will be a fantastic choice because it can literally do everything. I'm also going to be showing you some upgraded parts you can buy that will increase your cost, but will completely max this thing out. Now, there are two quick things we need to talk about before we talk about the parts for this build. First, all the parts for this build will be linked down in the video description and will also be on my kit page where they'll be nicely organized for you to check out. Second, this build is just going to detail the parts you need to purchase, not how to put them together. I have good news though. I made a video a while back detailing exactly how to put together a video editing PC from opening the boxes all the way to turning the computer on. And those instructions will still apply to this build as well. It's not hard, it's kind of like Legos. I will link to that video in the corner and in the video description. Also, incidentally, if you decide you want to spend less, I will link down below to my mid-tier 6K video editing PC build guide for $1,500, as well as my budget 4K video editing PC build guide, which will get you editing for only $750. Now it's time to jump into this $2,000 video editing PC build, and let's start with the brain of the computer, the CPU. The more cores and threads your CPU has, the faster it will be. And oh boy, do these options have a lot of those. I would recommend purchasing the AMD Ryzen 9 5900X processor, which has 12 cores and 24 threads and retails for $549. For context, this is literally double the amount of cores and threads from my budget video editing PC build guide, and it's so fast, you'll catch your beard on fire. This also happens to be one of AMD's newest processors, so you're pretty bleeding edge here. Now, I hear you though. Just like that Kylo Ren meme, you're yelling at me, more, more. I get it. Well, hold on to your lightsaber, because if you've got a bit more cash to spend, the top of the line Ryzen 5950X is for you. How does 16 cores and 32 threads of performance sound? This processor is going to laugh as you edit even Blackmagic RAW footage in 12K. It's stupid, I love it. Buy this if you've got the cash. Moving on, let's talk about cooling for both of these CPUs. Unlike AMD's cheaper CPU offerings, these do not come with a CPU cooler included, so I have two options for you. If you want things to be easy and don't plan on overclocking your CPU too much, go with the Cooler Master Hyper 212 Evo Air Cooler. It's like putting a Dyson hand dryer in your machine, but quieter. It'll keep it cool. But if you want to step things up to water cooling, because come on, water cooling is great, it makes you sound cool, and it's also very helpful if you're doing a lot of long video renders, I would recommend the NZXT Kraken X63 liquid cooler. And as a side note, if you're intimidated by liquid cooling, this is an all-in-one system, meaning it is completely sealed, you don't have to fill it up with water or anything, you just clamp it to your CPU and attach the fans and radiator to your case. It's super easy, I promise. Now let's talk about the motherboard. This is what's going to hold your CPU, RAM, graphics card, etc., and make them all work together. I would recommend purchasing the Gigabyte X570 Aorus. Aorus? I don't know how you pronounce it. Aorus Elite Wi-Fi motherboard. This is a very popular motherboard that offers pretty much every single feature you could need for fast video editing. You have a lot of inputs for internal and external hard drives. Wi-Fi is built in. It is stellar. The one thing that I want you to know is that because both of the 5900X and 5950X CPUs I recommended are so new, there is a chance you may need to update the BIOS of the motherboard to make it work. If that sounds like I'm speaking a foreign language now, you do not need to worry. All you will need is a USB flash drive and another computer that you can use to download a file to. I'll link to an article below walking you through exactly how to do it. I promise you it's easy. Now, let's talk about RAM, aka memory, aka what your computer needs to access your programs. Because we're going high end here, you're going to want a lot of RAM. I would recommend purchasing 64 gigabytes of Corsair Vengeance LPX RAM at 3200 megahertz, which should easily handle 4K and 6K footage. But if you're editing higher resolution footage or often editing longer videos that are over an hour in length, I would instead go all the way up to 128 gigabytes of Corsair Vengeance LPX RAM at 3200 megahertz. That should be plenty. Next, you have the SSD. This is what's going to store your operating system and any programs you want to use with your computer. One of the fastest SSDs available on the market today is the new Samsung 980 Pro SSD, and this build will be able to take full advantage of it. This drive goes up to 1 terabyte, but for this build, I think you'll be fine with the 500 gigabyte drive though. But if you find yourself needing more space, the Western Digital Black SN850 is a great option that's also super fast, and it does come in sizes of up to 2 terabytes. Please do keep in mind that I only recommend using the SSD to store your programs. For the fastest video editing speed, it's best to have one SSD that holds your programs and another SSD or regular hard drive to store your video files. And in your case, because you're going high end, go with the SSD. Also, if you're someone that travels a lot like me, I would recommend purchasing an external hard drive or SSD to edit your videos from. Alternatively, this computer's case will support internal hard drives and SSDs, so you could go that route too. I'll be sure to link to hard drives and SSDs that I recommend, both internal and external, down in the video description. Moving on, it's now time to talk about one of the most exciting parts of the computer, but especially on a high-end one, the graphics card. And this is where this build video is gonna be different from PC build videos I've made in the past. See, there have been a ton of awesome graphics cards released recently, but there are currently major issues in the supply chain, and many companies are having difficulty keeping cards in stock. It really is a perfect storm of a shortage of workers building these cards due to the pandemic, everyone staying home and wanting to play computer games, also due to the pandemic, cryptocurrency mining, which is always an issue with high-end graphics cards. And lastly, unfortunately, there are scalpers right now that are using bots to buy up most of the graphics card supplies as soon as they're in stock, and then turning around and selling them on eBay at a massive price markup, usually double or triple the MSRP. Because of all these issues, it is quite difficult to buy a graphics card for a reasonable price these days, which makes buying a video editing computer, even one where you have a large budget, even more difficult. Don't worry though, I'm here to help you save money. So here's what I'm gonna do for you in this video. In the past, I've recommended one particular brand and model of graphics card because cards would usually stay in stock. But now, instead of just one brand and model, I'm gonna recommend several brands and models of card. And so when you're buying a graphics card, you have the maximum chance of being able to find one in stock for a reasonable price. So here are my budget graphics card recommendations. First, let's talk brands. When you're looking for a graphics card, you're gonna see a lot of brands like Asus, MSI, EVGA, Gigabyte, Zotac, PNY, there are a ton. In my experience for video editing, it doesn't make a huge difference which brand you buy from. And with this shortage, we are much more concerned with actually finding a graphics card in stock. So if you find a card from any of the above brands, I would say you're probably good to go, as long as a card doesn't have horrible reviews online. So if all those manufacturers are generally good, which specific model of card should you buy? I've got 3 cheaper options for you and 2 more expensive options. Starting with cheaper, I would recommend the NVIDIA RTX 3080 and AMD RX 6800 and 6800 XT. These cards retail for an MSRP of $580 to $700 and are extremely powerful. If you can find them in stock new and not being sold for an outrageous price, I think they're great. But if you want to max things out and price is no object, in that case, I would consider the AMD 6900 XT and NVIDIA 3090. Starting at an eye-watering MSRP of $1,000 and going up to $1,500, these cards cost more than most computers, but wow, they are blisteringly fast. I will link below to all these cards that I just talked about that are in stock, but I can't guarantee they'll stay in stock because things literally change from hour to hour. because stock can be so hard to keep up with. I would recommend setting up stock alerts at Amazon, Newegg, and B&H so you can be notified as soon as they come back in stock. In addition, if you live close to a Micro Center or Best Buy and can go in person to the store, there's a much better chance that you may be able to find one in stock at a physical location. Last thing about graphics cards. If you find a store that has them in stock, please come back to this video and leave a comment telling others so they can filter by new comments and hopefully buy one as well. Almost finished with this build. We need to talk about the power supply and the case. And let's start with the case that you'll put all these parts inside. I recommend the NZXT H510. It's a beautiful case that doesn't look too flashy. And when I'm building a computer, I've learned that I would rather spend my money on a cheaper case with good airflow and save the rest for the parts inside it. If you want to go crazy though, there are much more expensive options out there that do look very cool. I'm also aware that there are some of you out there that want a case that has a 5.25 inch bay, so you can use an internal Blu-ray and DVD burner. Personally, I would rather purchase an external DVD or Blu-ray drive, and I will link to the ones that I recommend down in the video description. But if you want a case that can handle an internal optical drive, I would recommend the Fantex Enthu Pro M TG ATX Mid Tower case. This will run a bit more expensive than the NZXT H510, but it's a great choice that looks professional. Very last part, let's cover the power supply, which gives this computer the sweet, sweet electrical juice that it craves. If you're just buying the base version of this computer and none of the upgrades, then I think you'll have plenty of power with the EVGA BQ 850 watt power supply. But if you're buying any of the upgrades, especially the higher end graphics cards, I would recommend purchasing the EVGA 1000 watt P2 Platinum power supply. Both of these power supplies are fully modular, meaning it should be very easy to cable manage so your computer's wiring looks its best. With the power supply chosen, congratulations. That is your approximately $2,000 video editing PC. Of course, there are accessories that you will need to purchase as well, such as mouse, keyboard, speakers, and monitor, but a lot of those are going to come down to your personal preferences. I will link down in the description and on my kit page to the mouse, keyboard, speakers, and both a 1080p and a 4K monitor option for you to purchase. Because you're building a video editing machine this powerful though, I would definitely go with the 4K monitor option. As far as the operating system goes, I would recommend Windows 10. And I've included a link down in the description to a Tom's Hardware article where you can read about how to get a copy of Windows 10 for free or for very cheap. With that, thank you so much for watching. It would be a huge help to me if you would consider liking this video and subscribing if you want to see more videos like it in the future. Please keep in mind these PC part prices are subject to change and parts can go out of stock. If anything looks too expensive or goes out of stock, please let me know and I will update the part link with a new option. Lastly, I also have a budget video editing PC build guide and a mid-tier sweet spot build guide as well. And those are linked in the corner and description if you want to watch them. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.